Beach, Florida. Welcome wherever you are around the world. It's a pleasure to speak to you. Welcome to Believe. This is Nicholas Upchurch. Our company is called Love. Our website is believe.love. We are here to serve you and help you to improve your life. Join us on YouTube, youtube.com/believeloves you. iTunes, believeiTunes.com. Subscribe to our audio podcast. And believeAndroid.com for Android users. We have some exciting information for you today. I want to help you to change your life, to become more aware, to feel like you can be finally fulfilled and live your best life, no matter how much money you have or how much money you don't have, to feel hopeful, to feel that love surging through your body, to feel that you can do anything and accomplish anything through any adversity you may possibly face. That is our goal here. We cover so many great categories, really five major categories: money and business, true success, health and wellness, world news, and our universe. And I have some exciting information for you today, so welcome. If you want to help us, all you have to do is spread the links. Spread the links. Go to believe.love. Share the links with your friends. Spread the message. Leave us a comment. Email us at believe@believe.love. That's believe@believe.love. Ask me anything you want. I will help you personally. It's my honor. It's my honor to talk to you today or tonight, wherever you are in the world. And it's really exciting today. We're going to help you to begin with in the category of money and business. And I want to talk to you about something you may have encountered, again, no matter how successful or maybe unsuccessful we've been, right? And that's how to get through adversity and how to just have faith in yourself when you're trying to grow your business or make more money and things aren't going your way. How to get through adversity and continue to believe in yourself in terms of money and business. This is something really important because almost all of us have tough things happen at some point. We all hear these stories, and sometimes they're true. Many times they are true. Many times maybe they're not, but that's okay. You know, maybe there are people that forget to tell the whole story. So I can tell you for myself, in terms of adversity and money and in the category of money and business, because right now we do have to pay for things. We're trying to be successful, and for many people that's making a lot of money. So we have freedom and we can have an open schedule and help our families, and there's a lot of good intention behind that. And for me, there was good intentions too. And that's how we grow up in the United States in particular, sort of focused on this idea of success. So that's okay, it is what it is, right? So I have made a lot of money in a short amount of time, a couple times in my life. You know, basically businesses that were seven-figure plus businesses. Well, I would say seven-figure plus meaning over a couple million dollars very quickly in sales and a very high profit margin over a year or two period of time. Actually, probably a couple of times in my life with real estate and with digital marketing. And so, but I've also had really tough times. I've described it in some of our business videos in the past and some of the podcasts I was on. I've been on such as Entrepreneurs on Fire, which has 10 million downloads a month, eofire.com, that's a show I was on. John Lee Dumas is the host, one of the top business podcasts on iTunes. I highly recommend it. And, you know, there's been a lot of tough times, and many people out there have experienced tough times. And sometimes we hear these stories of companies growing and getting so large quickly and succeeding, and we need to take those into account. We need to learn from those. I think it's good to hear successful case studies, but the reality for most people is that things can be tough. It can be tough to succeed in business and with money, for a lot of reasons. And I've had more failures than successes, some might say. I've started projects that haven't worked. And I did an episode a while back that Michael Jordan said in a quote, how many shots he's missed at the end of the game. Like, he's missed more than he's made to win the game. So he made a lot of game-winning shots. The best basketball player of all time, Michael Jordan. He made a lot of game-winning shots, but he actually missed more shots than he made to win the game. And he talks about that and how important missing those shots became to his success. And the same with Abraham Lincoln, multiple bankruptcies, lost when it came to, I think, running for the Senate. All of these things that happened in Abraham Lincoln's life, there's a list of what we might call failures. And then he wins the presidency and he's known for really freeing the slaves in a way and ending slavery. And there's some people that say maybe there's more to the story, but the bottom line is that's what he's remembered for. And he talks about the importance of things that didn't work out. And so for me, it's no different. And for you either, wherever you are in your life, whether you're trying to become happier and you have a lot of money and you're worried about losing it, because I'm there right now. I mean, I have a lot of money. I had a lot of money in the past. I have a lot of money, relatively speaking. Some people have more, but I'm spending a lot right now. I did something, a business venture, sort of working from the heart and trying to do a good thing, sort of offering a yoga studio to Miami. I didn't give it a lot of time. It didn't really work as I planned it. And you know what? That's life. Like, that is the truth about making more money, having a great business, is that you're going to have things happen and you're going to be, you are human as well. Not you're going to be human. You're probably human if you're listening to this, but maybe some beings are not human that are listening to this, right? Who knows? But you're going to have some things come up that you're not expecting, or you're going to have weird reactions, or people are going to have weird reactions to you, and the sales funnel might not work, or just things might not be lining up. And so you can handle it a couple of ways. I'd say there's a combination of things that we can do. When we want to handle adversity and continue to build our business and make more money specifically. And we have to say that, you know, first of all, we've got to expect that these things are going to happen. I'd say that when they do, we can feel even stronger. We can feel stronger. So if you failed or you did something and it didn't work out, I want you to right now, and you know, this is how I feel right now, I'm going to feel even more confident. I'm going to feel even more confident that I can do it even more. You know what? If things knock you to the ground and you feel like you want to fail, that you want to give up, and you know, it's bringing tears to my eyes right now, it really is. But you get up off the ground and you just think about how lucky you are. And you know, I'm so lucky to be healthy, to have a beautiful space now in Miami here, to have some great people that want to be involved. We've now interviewed people for a media company, because really we're going to become a media company, and we have been a media company. I've had websites that we've had millions of visitors a month, and we've done celebrity interviews and things like that. So the yoga part for me was for fun, to kind of have a good vibe at our space and have some classes open to the public. And you know, nobody showed up. The marketing didn't work, and I didn't want to spend tens of thousands of dollars more for a business that really wasn't for the money. It was for, you know, yoga studios can't really make money. But my point is that, so it created a lot of tough feelings though, because I don't like when things don't work. Traditionally, I don't like that. That's how I view it. I view it as a letdown a little bit, and then people get frustrated and everybody wants it to work, and it might not be, and people start blaming each other, and it can be very tough. It can be very tough. So when things kick your butt, right? Just believe in yourself more. I remember I played football for the University of Michigan. And, you know, I had a fractured back at 15. And I'm pretty small in terms of football, the football world. And I had a fractured back when I was 15. I was in a brace for 6 months. The doctor said, you probably shouldn't play sports ever again when I was 15. And, you know, not only did I get healed and then do very well in high school, but then I played for a Big Ten school on the field. I got in some games, and I played before that at University of Central Florida, and I was the last guy on the, not even on the bench. I wasn't even, when I was a freshman, I was in the stands on the team. There's 120 players on a college football team in the United States, right? And I think 85 dress in the uniforms for home games and only 60 travel to away games. So by the sixth game of my freshman season, I was playing in the games. I went from in the stands to in the games. And I was fighting and clawing and anything, you know, breaking rules in practice, meaning just putting myself out there, getting yelled at, doing whatever I could. And my freshman year, I was on the field. And my sophomore year, I was on the field every single game. And we beat the University of Alabama at Alabama, which is a great school, of course, in football. In college football, they're one of the best, right? And so I had a fractured back. But when I played for Michigan, I won this big trophy called Champion of the Year, the team voted on. And then I sprained my ankle before the next season because I was running at night trying to get in shape for this 1 mile run. And I remember when I sprained that ankle, and I kind of knew that this was, you know, it was going to be bad news. I rolled it on a hurdle at the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor, sort of at this track that was open at night by the IM building near Hoover. Anybody who knows anything about Ann Arbor, Hoover was the street. And Ann Arbor, Michigan, and I looked at that ankle, and in this case, you know, I've had a lot of tough feelings, but I smiled at that ankle. You know, I just knew that, hey, this was really going to be tough now. And after winning that trophy the year before, and the coaches loved me, I mean, they loved me. I think they really liked, a lot of them really liked me. I was out of it. You know, I never missed a practice, but I couldn't run that well. I was a wide receiver. I needed to be fast, and I couldn't run. I didn't miss a practice, but I wasn't going to play in the games, and I started to get better in the middle of the year, but I was out of the mix. You know, I was out of the mix, so it was really disappointing, but when you get beaten down like that, smile. Smile. You know what? Smile. This is life. This is just, you're here to learn, probably. I didn't know this when I was that age. I didn't know this, but this is not, I've said this a lot of times on this show, and I'll keep saying it. You are not just your physical body. Look up the near-death experience study from the University of Southampton in the UK, where people see themselves after they die and their heart and brain have stopped for 3 minutes and doctors cannot explain it. And I could go on and on with, this is part of our reality. This is not our entire reality. But you and I, here we are. We're living here. We have to pay bills. We want to make more money. But just smile. If you could, smile. I had a great woman in our studio or our office space here in Miami Beach, Florida. And she was just telling me, you know, all this stuff. She's done this for over a decade, run yoga studios. In my opinion, it was an honor to talk to her. Very successful at running yoga studios in Miami Beach. And she just said, you know, we have to just laugh about all this stuff that I've encountered, just trying to do something nice for the community. And spending tens of thousands of dollars that really I shouldn't necessarily be spending. It's not going to help me make money. And she's like, you know, we just have to laugh at this stuff. She's like, because she's gone through it. she's gone through it for, you know, some tough things as well with, you know, people, if they're on time and this and that, and getting everybody on the same page and running a business, right? So she said, we just have to laugh. You know, there's World War III perhaps starting and this and that. So, and we'll talk about that. We talked about it a little on our last episode. But I would say, listen, if you can, wherever you are, you know, smile with me right now. Just think about how funny this is. What's the worst that's going to happen? I talked to a girl who was homeless in Hawaii. And she was happier than could be. She actually wanted to be homeless in Hawaii. Now, that's a pretty good place maybe to be homeless, right? But what is the worst that's going to happen? Now, if you have a family and kids, you can't quite think about that you're just going to go homeless, right? But what are we scaring ourselves for? What are we afraid of? You know, so I didn't, you know, I think a lot of it is that we think we have one life and that's it. And then we're dead and that's the end of us. Well, that's not the case. And I'm just saying this now. I'm thinking about that more and more. Like, where is this fear coming from? What are we afraid of? I think a lot of times it's like, oh, I have that one chance. And if it doesn't work, I've failed forever. Well, maybe in this body, but well, I don't know that you failed, but you've learned. You've learned and you're going to go on and continue to learn after this life and before this life. And even me saying that, I'm kind of blowing my own mind right now. Kind of blowing my own mind because I've thought about it, but I've almost never thought about it like that. But it's everything that has come to me from multiple sources over the past 2 or 3 years in terms of probably maybe Constantine taking reincarnation out of the Bible when the Catholic Church sort of came about in Rome. And if you take a look at the Book of Enoch, and it's possible Jesus was teaching reincarnation. That might be what he was teaching, reincarnation. And just a lot of other things in terms of past life regressions with Dr. Brian Weiss from Yale and his book, Many Lives, Many Masters. And he's not the only one. Dr. Ian Stevenson from University of Virginia, things I've mentioned in the past. But you're not failing. You're not failing. Even if you do nothing, even if you do nothing that you want, or hell, I don't know how many people are going to see this episode or hear it, but I'm proud if I can help you, and it's 3 people. Now, it's not. We're doing very well. We're getting thousands of people on YouTube and YouTube and iTunes and everything combined. Not a ton, though. Not a ton. We want to be at millions. We want to be with millions of people, but I appreciate anybody out there I can help. But you know what? I'm doing the best I can right now. And you are too. You are too. And if you think you aren't, just take the pressure off yourself. You're doing the best you can in this life. You can get better, so can I. We can all get better, whatever we think better is. But just take that pressure off yourself. You know, you'll be okay. You'll be okay. I think as a people, if we want to think about, as opposed to our personal success that's been driving us, which is, it's good, because in a way we think, well, capitalism, it drives success because people are improving products, right? So we have one company come out with something new, the iPhone, and then maybe another company will come out with a better phone or something, right? I still use an iPhone right now, but you know, things progress. There wasn't an iPhone before Apple came out with it. There were these fascinating other phones. What do we have? The Motorola flip phone. And then before that, anybody who's a little older, you remember the Zach Carr Saved by the Bell, the big brick cell phone from the late 90s, right? The car phones. Anybody out there remember the car phones in the 90s with the bag? You remember the bag? It cost like, I was in high school or something like that playing baseball. My parents had the car phone in the van with that bag, and they carried it around, right? And it cost like $2 a minute, so you never really used it, but you had the car phone if you tried to be awesome, right? We're trying to be awesome, I guess, right? So you're not failing. You're not failing. You can do it. Whether it's this lifetime or next lifetime, or you're gonna do it. You're gonna do it one way or another. You're gonna figure it out. You know, it's probably that we're patterns and frequencies. It's probably what we are, just to be clear. We've talked about that hard tables and the walls, and it's 99.99% empty space. What are you? Do you think you're just a body? I mean, I have a brain too, as far as I know. I knocked on my head right now. I think I have a brain. I hope so. I'm working on it, right? Well, what are you really? So the first part of getting through adversity in terms of money and business is taking the pressure off yourself and smiling, and just if we can try to be thankful. I want to be thankful for my health. Yeah, right now I'm feeling some monetary pressure. I don't like losing any money. But you know what? I make changes very quickly. Maybe a little bit, some would say a little bit too quickly. But the reason why I make changes quickly is because a lot of companies blow a ton of money and then they're just out of money. What do they say? 10% of businesses are ever successful, meaning profitable, something like that. So I've had businesses in the past that in a year or two with very little expenses are bigger than 10 yoga studios if they were full every day, you know, something like that. I mean, and they were very successful. And so, and working from the internet and doing whatever I wanted and going to 33 countries and everything else. So I have to actually remind myself that so I can help you guys. But no matter what somebody says, how perfect they are in terms of business, they've gone through some crap. They've gone through some crap. And if you're going through crap, the first thing is take some pressure off yourself. Smile at the crap. Smile at your sprained ankle. Smile at the fact that you just lost money, or your employees, whatever it is, your employees, they're not happy, and things didn't work out as they planned. And you know what? Life goes on. Some people are getting bombed. I can't even imagine some people's reality in this world that we're living in. I think, 50% of people are in complete poverty? I mean, I'm talking about less than a dollar a day. Like, I can't even imagine the realities that are going on. Here I am, sitting in this expensive office studio in South Beach, Miami, going back to my condo on the ocean where I look at I'm in a $1 million condo right now. I'm renting it. The real estate market, I think, is at the top. I've done that whole thing. I'm not gonna buy at the top, buy at the bottom. Last time when I was really young, I bought at almost the top, and I kinda screwed myself there. But it's all a learning process, right? So, and I've been this way before, but you know what? I'm actually way happier now. I'm more thankful, and I'm thankful because I can help you, whatever situation you're in. So I remember being 2008, and I was miserable looking at the ocean with an ocean view in Miami Beach, talking to beautiful girls, and just something was, I don't know what was wrong with me. I was angry as hell. I mean, because, things weren't working as the market crashed. I was having a tough time with money, meaning I refused to get a normal job. Real estate was completely dying, and I could see that I was going to have some issues. And you know what? And it drug out for 4 or 5 years because I tried some things. I didn't quite have some patience. And eventually things took off and it was better than real estate, you know, a couple years ago. But that's the reality of people. The reality of people in business is that, first of all, we have our interesting quirks, right? So you have to really, really accurately assess where you're at. Meaning, what are you actually going to do? Like, I think for a lot of people, including myself, it's like, all right, if I want to be an NBA basketball player, is that possible right now? Like, what am I actually going to do that? Like, I'm 36, so it's not going to happen right now. But like, no matter what you do, you have to really figure out where you're at and accurately take into account your skills and then what you're actually going to be able to get done. And you might have to get an assistant on Upwork.com for a couple dollars an hour or whatever. But by the way, it's tough to find a good one. People say get an assistant, outsource things. Okay. Well, it comes down to, you know, here's what everything comes down to, I think, in this life, if you want to know the truth. Because I'm moving across several topics. So we can try to be successful ourselves. We can move things forward with capitalism, meaning you're coming out with better products, you're competing with people. But ultimately, are we competing with people? We're just coming out with better things. So in a way, we're helping everybody, but we think we're competing with other companies, but not really. I mean, the reality is that we're just spreading money around. I mean, even me, when I think I lost money, well, I just gave it to other people. The building gets money. Yelp gets money. Ran some Yelp ads for the yoga studio. I don't know. I don't even think it. I don't know if it did well. I'm sure it could. I don't know. The employees got money. So, you know, they helped. And so did I lose? I don't know. Not really. What did I mean, I still have some money. I could still go home and eat. Now I need to get on it so that we get money coming in, and we're gonna do that with our media part of our company. But if I was all about money, I would be in Silicon Valley or something else and totally focused on sales. And if, you know what, as much as you could watch videos about sales and money only, you're not gonna. Is that really why you're here? I mean, you do need to make money for your family, and we are paying bills right now. But I can tell you from experience, like I was telling you, I had a lot of money a couple times. I was angrier than hell. I was angrier than hell. The only thing that makes me happier is harmonizing myself and working through the tough things in my life. That is what is really making me happy. And that will allow you to make more money. And that will allow you to get through adversity and make more money and build a business. Because when you get through those tough things, let's say, listen, you don't pay attention to details. So first of all, just as humanity, as in terms of humanity, maybe this is why I'm here. We need to tell the truth more, and we need to do what we say we're gonna do. That's it. So let's start there. That's spiritual to me. That's spiritual to me. And I've talked to people who run spiritual communities that are very successful. And you got people who are late, who don't do what they say. And you know what? You can't even run a community when people are late and not doing what they say. And I can do a better job of that too. But I'm pretty good. Pretty good. Not perfect. Pretty good. Pretty good. So, when we work through adversity, when we work through the tough things in our life and harmonize those tough things and forgive ourselves and others, I forgive myself for not having this yoga place be full. I tried, I got it together in 60 days. I know some studios, we heard a story of a yoga studio taking a year and then nothing happened and they closed as well. Nobody came to the classes. So I'm talking about this example because it doesn't matter what it is. You may create a landing page and a product online and go to sell it, and your conversion rate will be terrible, perhaps. Hopefully it's not. But and you're like, I've done this before. I've made seven figures online. And I've done this before, before I did that, where seven figures, like, I've generated millions of dollars in sales, and I've done these things. I am by no means perfect, but I am real. I'm real. I've also lost hundreds of thousands of dollars, but I thank God I have a little bit more than I lost, right? But the reality is that you could do all this work on something, and to you it's great, and you put it out there and nobody's buying it or nobody's opting into your report or whatever you're trying to do online, or you could come out with a new product, or you could write a book or whatever, and nobody cares. In a way, maybe a couple people care, and you could be like, this sucks. Like, I did all this work, nobody even cares. So how you can get through that is to really work through those tough things that are preventing you from paying attention a little bit closer. So let me tell you a couple of mine, right? So first of all, just being around people in person, after you have an online business and you have all this freedom, for me, having employees in person and everything again, like, I wanted to build a community and be comfortable around people again. The positive side about having freedom and doing whatever you want, and it's, you go around, I've been all over the world. And then what? And then what? You know, you make some good friends that you know, but then you get a little older, your friends get married, they have kids. Okay. So then you figure, like, why are you really here? I went through this whole evolution I've talked about on other shows. But you can wonder, like, why am I here? What am I here for? And am I supposed to just be not trusting people and just living for myself? Like, that's great, but what's my purpose? I mean, you make money and then what? And I've talked to people who have made millions of dollars on our show here. Believe. You go back and you watch the episode with Damian Lupo, L-U-P-O. You can go to believe.love and watch that episode. But he went through the same thing. And these are people that made a lot of money. So I'm dealing with this, and when I start this process, I have a lot of, like, weird energy coming up, like tension and fear, a lot of fear. And I don't know why, because it's in my subconscious, and because I had, you know, because of reliability and people not paying attention to details, and because it used to make me mad, and I don't know, because of just trusting people and trusting myself to deal with people, whatever. It is what it is. Nothing terrible happened. Some people are getting killed in other countries, so this is child's play. And that's why, like I said, you know, I sprained my ankle playing football at the University of Michigan. It's just a game. It's men in tight pants running around a field spanking each other on the butt. Now, when I was that age, I thought it was like do or die, like this is the reason for life, but it's just a game. It felt like more than a game. So some of what I need to work through to pay attention better, or some of what I have been working through, because I'll tell you what happened with me. Everything came up, and then I found peace, and I was able to talk with people more and just accept that some employees and things just aren't gonna do exactly what I think. and some will. And you know what? We can always hire more people if things aren't going right. It's not the end of the world. It's just like you can say, hey, you know, it's tough though when you're spending thousands and thousands of dollars and you're losing money and you look at it that way that, yeah, I mean, business can put pressure. We can put pressure on ourselves. I mean, if you have a family and you've got a business venture, it can freak you out if things are not going well. And if you're funding it all yourself, and for me, I put a lot of I went away from just making millions. I mean, I was going to Silicon Valley. In 2008, I had an executive summary, and then in the coming years, I had meetings with attorneys in Silicon Valley, people that really liked our ideas, my idea, really. And I could be out there. I could be running a tech company. I had angel investors interested. I could have gone all in on just making a ton of money. And you know what? You can do both. You can do both. Ultimately, when there is free energy, we can just use money to trade. We can end poverty with free energy and some of the technologies that have been hidden. But you know what? It's not there right now. But you can do both. You can make a lot of money and you can be happy. But I'm going to tell you the way to it, the only way to it for me is working through these tough things, working through that adversity, and then really analyzing yourself or sort of noticing yourself, becoming aware of yourself and what everybody else can actually do that is working for you, if you have people working for you, and working through those tough things that come up when the adversity comes up. You know, and just allowing it to happen and not demonizing yourself and feeling like a failure because you're not. And then feel stronger when it happens. Feel stronger. It doesn't mean that you need to say everybody else is wrong, but meaning because, you know, feel stronger like you're fighting anybody. You're not fighting anybody. You're not competing with anybody. You're competing with yourself. Look in the mirror. That's who you're competing with. Same with me. This is really, it's just about knowing thyself, right? Knowing thyself. It's probably why you're here. You're a part of a energetic being, probably, that is learning about itself. And we have a body right now, and that's how we're rocking it out, through our body, through this world. So the next step, after you sort of work through things and smile and have that resolve, is to really focus in on what will actually work. Scrape all that debris off, right? So right now it's like, all right, this didn't work out. I'm going to tell you what I did this week. I closed classes to the public, these yoga classes. We had a couple employees are like, oh, can you keep one yoga class? Having one yoga class in a yoga studio is like going to a grocery store and there's one loaf of bread, right? It's not going to make any money. Even if the yoga studio was full, it's not going to make any money. So I'm like, we're going to close the classes to the public. We're going to focus on things online. And we're going to build our media company and focus in on what can work. And ultimately, what can make money as well, because that's what pays for everything. That's what pays for everything. So you go back to your bread and butter and what's working, and then you expand from there. And, you know, some things might work the next time. So that's how you do it. You know, let all the debris, get all the debris out. Basically, become more efficient and focus in more on what's working, whatever is working. And then build from what's working. After you take your little test run, and if things don't work, and you have your adversity and you feel like crazy and things aren't working out, you know, scrape off everything and then go back to what's working. Go back to what's working and believe in yourself at that point. That's going to be a key. That's something I have to do right now. Believe in yourself that things can be successful. then, maybe more good things can come. It's very interesting about this yoga studio. It came together so quickly. Everything seemed perfect. There were 20 people that showed up. I literally hired 20 people, or 17 or 18, in a month, and people were on time, which is a miracle in many cases. And it was just coming together so almost like magically. And I had people telling me that. I was on another show and they were telling me it's magical and all this stuff. Well, it could be, but just 'cause it didn't work out, and you might have something you feel like is meant to be and it's not perfect. Who's deciding it's not perfect? Maybe this is perfect. Maybe it was never supposed to be like this, or should I say, it helped to grow into what it's going to become quicker, right? I mean, we're all living on land in the United States, which the Indians used to own. I mean, things are not so perfect as they progress. We can keep that in mind. So once you, when you're working through adversity, you're smiling at it. You're smiling because ultimately there's more to, you didn't fail in this life no matter what happens. You're not a failure. You're not a failure. You're smiling at it because you know what? People have it worse somewhere, and we all know that, but we're all going through our perspective. But you smile at it because you know what? Who gives a damn? Smile at that adversity. Work through all the things that come up. That's step two. Work through them and feel them. Allow yourself to become more comfortable and aware as those tough things come up. And the third thing is really go get into what works and take note and really focus and make bullet points and get on what's working and scrape off all that debris and get back to that. And then believe in yourself is the fourth thing you can do. Believe in yourself. And then number five, be thankful for the people that come and reinforce those feelings of things will be okay. So in my case, I had a yoga studio owner show up, and it just felt so good. She's the one person. I was doing this yoga studio thing for fun, like for the community. I wasn't even gonna make any money. I don't even know why I did it. I mean, I was thinking about before I signed this lease for this great place. I'm like, well, do I want to do this, or do I want to just chill on the ocean and have my online business and do this show, Believe, and help people out, and then just be chilling on the ocean? And do I want to just do that? Like, that might be cool. And I decided to do it, right? And I'm glad I did because we have more people coming that are great, that are going to help us. And we're going to create a set here. It's going to be amazing. And we're going to create a real positive news network. And I want to run it all the time. I want to run it 24 hours. All these, I want to have it be live all the time. I mean, there's a lot of people that would love to contribute, and I would love to make it a 24-hour network. Can you imagine 24 hours of positivity in these categories? Money and business, true success, health and wellness, world news, our universe. Positivity helping you 24 hours a day. That's what I would like. I would like to actually have it in Vegas as well. Vegas, by the way, there's no state income tax, just like Florida. We're in Florida now. Vegas, of course, is in Nevada. And I lived there for about a year, a couple years ago. And I would love to have East Coast and West Coast and just have this be positive all the time. So when the last thing, step five, people that reinforce that things will be okay, maybe like me, for you now, wherever you are in with adversity, be thankful. Be thankful for those people. I mean, I was so thankful. That teacher, that owner of the yoga studios, just the fact that she could understand and relate to some of the tough things that had happened made me feel so good, like relief, like, man. I wish that it was such a perfect timing. And so maybe this episode is for you. Perfect timing in your life to know that you can get through whatever adversity you're facing in your journey towards making more money. We have a episode previously on believe.love, our website, about if you're trying to get a better job, and I go through steps you can take to do that. We have videos on it, how to grow your business specifically at believe.love. It's all free there. And so, you know, specifically speaking, there's a lot more information. We interview people that have grown great businesses and built million-dollar plus businesses at believe.love. We've had some really famous people at believe.love. But I'm here to serve you. I'm here to serve you. And it's an honor to help you succeed. And I want you to connect with me personally. I want to connect with you. I want to know who you are, what you're trying to accomplish. I want to help you more personally. So email us, believe@believe.love. Let me help you, please. I would love it. It'd be an honor to help you personally. And again, find us on YouTube, youtube.com/believeloves you. And on iTunes, believeitunes.com, Android, believeandroid.com. And wow, this has been a really fulfilling episode. I hope that you loved it. I hope that it helped you. And it's been a great ride, and it's an honor to be with you. So thank you for joining us on Believe.